What's up, YouTube? It's your boy, Ollie the Rock. And I didn't have to go on my trip after all because the truck that I was going to use broke down. So I don't have to do it until next week now. So, oh well, life is such it is. So I'm so excited because I knew it was coming today. Guess what I got in the mail? Yep, I got it right there. Yep, right there. It's so cool. So check it out. For those that haven't got it yet. So that's the inside. There's those. And then the master. Oh, sorry about the glare. And then there's that one. Sorry. There's a glare and I can't see it. There you go. And then the other side. That's the other side right there. There's the original date. If I can get a little closer without it blurry. Yeah, it's too blurry. That's the front cover. And there she is. Pretty cool. So excited. So this comes with a Blu-ray. It's got a CD 1 and CD 2. So I'm pretty excited. So let me give you a rundown real quick. I know it's not part of this video, but I got it. I had to share it. So on CD 1, you have Swan Heart, End of All Hope, Wish I Had an Angel, 10th Man Down, Come Cover Me, Gethsemane, Elan, Sacrament of Wilderness. Wow, I didn't realize that was on there. Deep Silent Complete, Dead Boy's Poem. And then there's like three other ones. And then on the second CD, there's like another 8 songs. So in total, there's quite a few songs on here. So I'm pretty excited. And then, of course, the Blu-ray has the actual Greatest Show on Earth and Ghost Love Score. Some of the other ones are on there as well. So I'm looking forward to checking this out. And I will be doing reaction videos to this as well. Oh, I'm so excited that it came. And I didn't have to go to California. Even better. All right. So, anyway, this is going to be Nightwish, making of the new album of 2015, episode 11, 12, and 13. Pretty excited. And since I didn't have to go, I figure I'd redo the video because I already had it already done. But I got the... video or the CD, so I had to share the experience. Just, you know, it's floor. I know, I'm a goof. What do you expect? All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1, go! Elan.
February 13th was a special day for the band, and for the fans as well. That was the day when the first single from the new Endless Forms Most Beautiful album was released. And as we all know by now, the first single was Elan. But was that the original plan?
Nope.
Valintahan oli tosi helppo siinä mielessä, että se oli ensimmäistä Hattulan demotussessiosta, mikä tehtiin Teron kanssa, niin se oli ihan selkeä, että se tulisi olemaan tämä Idiman
Room,
eli levyn 8. biisi. Mutta sitten oltaisiko me 2-3 viikkoa treenattu bändin kanssa tuolla Röyskössä, ja sitten Marko ja Troy lähestyi varovasti, että olisiko se kuitenkin tämä Ilään, että tässä on semmoinen niin mukavan haikea meininki Kertsissä, ja tämä on paljon, Marko sanoi, että on paljon parempi biisi hänen mielestä, että vaihdetaanko. Ja siinä vaiheessahan me oltiin tehty jo videokäsikirjoitusta, ja kaikenlaista muuta suunnittelua nimenomaan tämän toisen biisin pohjalle, että se vähän mietit, että pystytäänkö me tässä vaiheessa vielä vaihtaa ekaa sinkkuun. Hyvin pystyttiin. Ja oikeassa olivat.
Yeah, Elan. Elan, it was It was the prime candidate for a single. I think when we started rehearsals with the songs, there were three in line as the first single, and Ilan just hit us all as being perfect for the first single.
Leaving the demo version behind and going back to 2015, what makes a good single?
Mistä sen tietää, että tämä on se single? Mitä single-biisistä pitää löytyä?
En meinaakaan tiedäkään, pitääkö sinulta muilta?
It's generally something that is instantly accessible, instantly hits the person on first listen. That's the main element for a single. But that doesn't necessarily mean that the rest of the album is going to follow suit, which it certainly does not.
The video for this song was shot in 11 days in 8 different locations. The idea was to bring abandoned places back to life and simply celebrate the beauty of life itself.
Again, it's nice to be surprised, and I was really surprised how brilliant it is. It's really, really brilliant, and Ville's done a just sensational job on it.
Aivan huikea tekellä. Niin kuin äsken sanoin Villelle, niin aihe on todella vaikea saada tollanen toimivaksi sillä tavalla, että sitä videosta jäisi katselijalle positiivinen, hyvä mieli, laittaisi leveän hymyn kasvoille ilman, että se tuntuu missään vaiheessa vitsiltä. Ja se on just sellainen.
That's all for now. More clips from Nightwish Camp soon.
Yep. Next. All right. Take this off real quick. So a couple things I do like about the fact that how they picked the single, first and foremost, you notice that Tomas never really said that he's the one that actually picked it. It was really Marco that suggested it, or as the comment says, kindly requested or kindly suggested. I think that's pretty cool that they're able to talk that way and actually get good communication and that nobody's feeling dominant about the whole thing. I know I've said it throughout the videos, but I keep seeing it over and over. It's a collaboration with each other. It's not one person leading the charge. You know what I mean? Even though Tomas is actually the pen, if you want to call it that way, the pen that writes all this stuff down, and actually the band collectively pushes that pen throughout the entire song. I don't know if that makes any sense, but just an interesting observation. All right, ready? Number 12. Here we go. This is really cool. I like this.
Endless Forms Most Beautiful is not a concept album per se, but during the writing there were certain recurring themes. One source of inspiration was the work of Richard Dawkins.
Levyllä on tämmönen, voisiko sanoa, tieteellinen lähestymistapa moniin asioihin. Biisit niin kuin Shatter Before the Beautiful tai Endless Forms Most Beautiful, The Greatest Show on Earth, Alp and Glow, niin jollain tavalla heijastelee tällaista olemassaolon ihanuutta, sen hetkellisyyttä, evoluutiota.
There's that word, evolution.
Voisiko jopa sanoa, että tämmöistä tieteen runollisuutta. Luonnontieteet ja tämmöinen ajattelutapa tuntuu monille ihmisille olevan hyvin kylmä, jopa tylsä ajattelutapa. Ja se on yksi asia, mitä me toivottavasti saadaan tuotua tällä levyllä esiin, että tiede voi olla äärimmäisen, voisiko jopa sanoa, hengellinen kokemus.
Sagan,
we're speaking about a huge subject here, so it's probably right to assume this was not just a passing whim.
Nope.
Ei tämä mikään uusi juttu ole, että 6-vuotiaasta lähtien mä oon halunnut olla biologi. Äiti tietää kertoa, että mä oon aina halunnut olla
meribiologi. Since he was six.
Ja se ihminen ei varmaan koskaan ole lähtenyt
since he was six.
Sisältä pois, että jossain vaiheessa musiikki vei mennessään. Ja
I'm so
nyt
glad
sitten
he did not.
7 levyä tehtiin enempi tai vähempi eskapismi hengessä, niin nyt se sitten nosti päätään ja nämä teemat tuli esiin.
Levyn teemahan on täydellinen, koska niinku se, että miten me ollaan synnytty, miten totta kai meistä aika jättää, niin me jätetään oma jälkemme tähän maailmaan. Että,
the old age question.
Se on aika uskomaton, niinku, uskomaton teema.
That's it for this time from the Nightwish camp. See you soon.
All right. You know, the whole presentation of the theme of the album is super, super cool. Have you guys ever looked at the actual album itself and look at the cover? There's so much going on in that cover, which kind of leads you to each song that's in the album itself. You could see it from the songs to the album, you can actually see, if you just look at the cover, it's all about the growing process of evolution from the big explosion to, you know, like The Greatest Show on Earth when he starts out with the fireworks. You know, it's kind of the whole concept of boom, life is creating, and then the slow progression into it. And then, of course, the finale. But I just think it's an interesting dynamic of how Tomas puts all those things together and uses things of today to express his story to give to other people. Just, it's a beautiful thing. All right, the last episode for today. No. There she is.
Time becomes quite elusive when so much is happening and so much has happened that changed my life fundamentally. So I can't believe it's been years, and I can't believe how normal things are in a good way. Like, okay, this is my life today. I'm living in Finland. I'm the singer of Nightwish. I'm extremely proud and happy with the new album. And then there was that first show back in 2012 in
Holy
Seattle
cow.
That feels like yesterday and 100 million years ago. Like I said, time's elusive.
Do you see the pat in the back?
Endless Forms Most Beautiful
right
marked the first Nightwish studio session.
I didn't notice
two
that
band members.
The first time
Jensen
when I first
remembers
saw
how it all started like it was yesterday.
The show.
His demos for
but
me
in, that one
in
clip,
the past have always been rough instrumental parts where I start to make my vocals onto. So this was the first time that I got a demo home with music that was sort of already done. Of course, with space to change things, but this is the instrumental, this is the piano playing your vocal melodies, here are the lyrics.
Which is probably new to her, because she had to write her own music before.
And later when I look back, I realize how fantastic it is to get the Nightwish demo as a singer, and it's a virgin song that you can put your hands on and get, you know, make it ready, make it into a full song, ready for the world. That those steps I needed to make in retrospect. Oh yeah, wow, how awesome. And yeah, now I know the melody, and oh yeah, the lyrics, they're awesome. How do I fit that, and what kind of vocal type, and how was the dynamics? But those were the steps that came after.
The other first-timer sits behind the drum kit.
No siis, itse asiassa ei kyllä jännittänyt, koska tavallaan mä mietin sitä,
että
kuka tahansa tähän samaan tilanteeseen joutuu, niin on yhtä kusassa kuin meikäläinen. Eli periaatteessa niin kuin, mä yritin vaan keskittyä siihen, että saadaan, niin kuin, saadaan asiat tehtyä. Ja siis aikataulu oli aika nahkainen niin sanotusti. Eli kahdessa päivässä opettelet 78 minuuttia musiikkia, niin hyvää onnea kaikille vaan.
78 minutes of music in 2 days.
The band first began rehearsing the songs without vocals. Curiosity soon won, however, and the schedules were revamped.
Yeah, I was just curious how the place would look like, and I stepped by just to say hi because I hadn't seen the guys for a while, and yeah, how was it going to be like, and I had no idea. And then I stepped into the room, the guys were playing, and, oh, wow, this is awesome. But yeah, 5 minutes later, I was like, yeah, but I know this song. It's kind of stupid, I'm just sitting around here, where's the microphone?
Mun mielestä niin kuin helpointa tässä oli se, että kun Floor oli kuitenkin niin kuin laulamassa. Eli sä kuulet sen kokonaisuuden, niin kuin, mitä niin kuin bändi on tekemässä. Eli on basso, kitara, kiipparit, laulu ja Troy. Se oli niin kuin helpompi jollain tavalla saada se kokonaiskuva siitä, että miltä tämä musa kuulostaa ja mihin Floor laulaa, millä rytmityksellä, mihin sä voit ottaa fillejä. Missä tavallaan niin kuin mennään, niin kuin se oli niin kuin oikeastaan se tärkeä juttu.
Yeah, it was just a, sort of like a jam of songs that were, you know, that we started to learn and to get a feeling into, and then yeah, we just started playing it and me singing it, and that felt like yes, let's not stop this anymore.
Under the light, riding knots till the end of time.
That's it for this time. The journey continues. Onwards, ahoy!
So, what'd you guys think? So there's three episodes. I really, really dig the whole process. It gives you just a whole different appreciation of A, the band, the vocals, the setup, the process of how the song came about, why it came about. I mean, there's so much great input and information that when you listen to it, you're looking at it and going, wow, yeah, I remember that. And that made a lot more sense. And you're looking at it going, God, this is such an epic song. And when somebody says it's an epic song and they've actually done the research and have gone through the process, guess what? They really mean that it's an epic song. Because there's a lot of us, and I'm guilty. I've done it myself where I hear something, God, this is such an epic song. Not really realizing or even grasping how epic this song really, really is. Do you understand what I'm saying? So I really appreciate the value of these videos that they give to the overall essence of the songs. Just saying, that's my little 2 cents, as I always like to say. But anyway, hey, thank you so much. I'm so glad that I didn't have to go to California after all. I'm so happy. I will catch you guys tomorrow for some more wonderful reaction videos, specifically I think it's 11, 12, 13, so maybe 14, 15, 16. There's 22 videos. And then on the last one, I will be doing one of the songs from that album that we will be going through it and actually reacting to it after we've seen everything. It would be appropriate to actually do it at the end of this process, because that would just like the cherry on top of the ice cream, the cake, whatever. Anyway, hey, this is your boy Ali the Rock. We'll see you guys next time, and as always, stay metal.